Hello, Aries. Welcome to your reading. Let's go ahead and start us off with some deep breaths and get into these affirmations. This is a general energy update. Let's get into it. What is the energy for our Aries? Okay, a whole lot on the self, obviously. There are some things to remind our Aries. There are some things to take heed on. Okay, I'm hearing don't make sudden movements. Don't make sudden decisions, okay? Keep yourself in the energy of light. Being lighter, being brighter, okay? I hear it in my voice. I went from being very melatonin to brighter, okay? There may be a Scorpio in your life at this time. Number 22 can also be very significant, okay? Let's get into what the Scorpio card is saying. I am reminded to also tell you, Aries, to choose to focus on the latter side of things, okay? That is important. That is heavy also. I feel this also myself, and I feel the need to share to our Aries that there is this nauseating feeling that I have in my stomach. I just feel it in my bones. I feel it in my body, and I don't quite know where it's coming from, but I feel like Taurus season, like stepping into this season, it is having us realize a lot about what was done to us, if that makes sense. Okay. And collectively, I feel like we're feeling this a lot. We are feeling a lot of what wrong was done to us and the evil that was done to us. Okay, take this as it resonates. And what's happening here is that while you may be feeling this coming to surface, how much of your body is tensing up? It doesn't feel nice. It feels very nauseating. You feel the need to have to put up fences around you, right? Perhaps you've gotten used to, your body has gotten used to defending itself so much, because that's all you do. You're in this constant defending. Your body is tired. Your body is coming back to that. You're having feelings and moments of feeling like you need to defend yourself when you actually don't need to. And it's crazy that I'm saying this to you, Aries, because I'm feeling this for myself as well. This is happening to me right now in my life. And as you are feeling these emotions and these feelings coming to the surface, how much of you, your body is defending itself for no reason whatsoever. Like, it's coming back to being more tense, right? You may have moments of like wanting to come back to be more in defense. And this is making your body feel more tense. Do not do that. Do not do that. Okay. Yourself is wanting to feel itself. Okay, coming back to feminine energy. Yourself is wanting to come back to being more light and feeling, most importantly, feeling more light. Sometimes we don't allow this to happen, which means we are blocking ourselves from our blessings at the same time. Sometimes we don't allow ourselves to be more soft and to allow ourselves to be more soft because of the past, just experience on people being evil to you or doing evil things and you don't understand why they do evil things, let me tell you something. Hear me. These people who do evil things to us don't actually know that they're doing evil things. Does that make sense? They are so unconscious of doing evil to you that they are not even actually, they don't even know they're actually doing evil to you because they are so unconscious of themselves. How important it is to come back to self and to self-soothe. How important it is to be more light with our physical body because we're doing good to the self. So these people who have done you wrong, mistreated you, manipulated you, these people who have done evil things to you, you are trying to understand why. But these people who are doing evil things to you and have done evil things to you, maybe not doing evil things to you now so much than what they have done to you in the past, don't even understand why they did the evil to you. They don't even know why they did the evil to you. Light and love and the energy of love is so strong and so powerful. Hear me. The energy of love and the energy of light and the energy of being more soft and being more amazing to yourself. The energy of love is so strong that these people who come to you and approach you with evil intent don't even know why. They don't even know why. They act such things, such ways. They don't even know why. So when we, as a collective, and not just our Aries, but as a collective, when we experience evil, right? When we experience evil being done to us, we are like, why? When I have done nothing to you, right? Do not quarrel with a man for no reason if he has done nothing to you. I want to say this is Proverbs, okay, 31, I want to say, okay, I'm not sure about that, but I think it is Proverbs 31. Do not quarrel with a man who has done nothing to you, for no reason, who has done nothing to you, for no reason whatsoever. Do not quarrel with a man for no reason whatsoever if he has done nothing to you. What is your reason anyway? These people don't even know why. These people don't even know why they do evil things to you and why they did evil things to you. Okay? The energy of love is so powerful, Aries, that while you may find yourself in the energy of love, and you, I'm getting that you are in the energy of love, and while you may be finding yourself in the energy of love, you are attracting everybody. I think I said this to our Virgos as well. And there are some with intentions that are not very kind. Okay, again, number 22 is significant. Something about Christmas, okay? Something happened Christmas time. Along with the Scorpio is what I'm picking up here. I'm just putting this together, so I'm hoping this is making sense for some of you. Do not end up feeling this way because of one's approach towards you. Does that make sense? Do not feel this way about yourself because of someone else's wrongdoing or someone else's intention towards you. You are not, in fact, this thing or, you know, whatever it is that they're saying about you. You are not that. It is just that when you are in the energy of love, it is powerful and even blinds the devil. It blinds the unwholesome. The energy of love is so powerful that it blinds the narcissisms, the narcissism. It blinds the act of narcissism, which makes them act weird towards you because they don't actually know how to act right. When you are in the energy of love, you are correct, divine. Yes? So when there is somebody who's stepping into your life and approaching you with evil intent, that cannot prosper. It cannot prosper. You are the divine. You are love. And even the blind, even the narcissism, even the unwholesome cannot prosper. The only thing that they can do is be whatever they are to you, which is false. Narcissism is false. Unwholesome is false. Fear is false. So whomever is approaching you with fear, whomever is approaching you with this kind of intent, it is false. It will not prosper. Although Aries is in the right, in the energy of love. When you are in the energy of love, you are in the right. Yes. When you are in the energy of fear, you are false. Whether we like to hear it or not. For our Aries, our assignment is to get right with the self after everything that was done to you. Does that make sense? It is getting to the bottom of the self and what the self wants you to do and wants you to be, which is getting right with yourself and being in the energy of love. You have been in a place of indecision here. I use my intuition in all aspects of my life. Heavy emphasis on Mercury retrograde and what Mercury retrograde had left you feeling. Take that as it resonates. Stepping out of it in more light. Okay, and more in light. I'm reminded to tell you that. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. That is a heavy message, honesty. To get right with the self, to get right and rooted with the self, you must be honest with yourself, even when others are not being honest with you, and they are not going to be honest with you. I need to tell you that. They're not going to be honest with you. We hope, right, that people would, but they aren't actually going to be honest with you. That is a personal problem. When you have placed yourself in the energy of love, Aries, when you have placed yourself, especially when it comes to your energy, I was going to say your mind, but you have wands here, so I'm feeling like it's more of your energy, energetically, where you are energetically. When you place yourself in the energy of love, are you making yourself right and correcting yourself as well? And then correcting yourself physically. This is heavy emphasis on Taurus season. Physically, you're correcting yourself physically. You are to correct yourself physically is what I am reminded to tell you, to be more in gratitude and to be more honest with yourself. Thank you, Aries. I will honor the physical vessel that enshrines my soul. And are you only going to get your body right exactly where it needs to be and away from this? Thank you. Aries, thank you for this reading. I am available to do personal readings at this time. All of my information will be down in the description box below. I love you guys so much. Happy spring. And Taurus season is going to teach you a whole lot. We don't know of it, what it is of it just yet. But I feel like Taurus season is going to teach you about the self and a whole lot about the self. All right. I love you guys so much, Aries. I will see you in the next. Take care of yourselves. Bye.